Hey there! Today we're going to talk about different orbital parameters such as prograde, retrograde, normal, antinormal, radial in, and radial out. So to get started, we have a diagram here of the Earth or another object in space, and we have something orbiting around it. Here we have an axis across the Earth, just so that we understand where we're looking at, and up here is the rotational axis of the object. And in this case, we're going to be using the same rotational axis as the object itself, the parent object. We won't get into the torsion effect or other parameters that are required to help with frameshift drag reference and everything else. So prograde is the angular velocity of the object along its orbital path. And if it is a circularized orbit, such as this one here, the prograde is going to be the angular velocity. If you haven't taken a look at our circular motion video, I recommend you do it now before resuming this one. So our prograde is this, and our retrograde is the opposite. A prograde burn would actually extend the orbit outward in such a fashion, and a retrograde burn would lower the orbit, where your apoapsis and periapsis change in regarding to your prograde and retrograde velocity. Radial in and radial out are an interesting one. Radial in will actually cause your orbit to shift or to move. Let's take a look at a little reference here. Imagine that you were rotating around this marker in this direction, and you were to burn with a radial in, your orbit would shift, just like that. And alternatively, with a radial out, your orbit will shift in the opposite direction. With normal and antinormal, this is about your orbital inclination. So if you were to burn in the normal direction, you would increase your direction, but you also have to be careful to account for a prograde increased apoapsis. That's about it. What is an orbit? Really quick. An orbit is a balance between gravity and angular velocity. You have the force of the object pulling you down, and you also have angular velocity keeping you going. So when we take a look at the radial in and radial out, you'll notice that it seems as if it's pointing almost exactly at the center of the parent object. And this is relatively the case, but not always. Keep that in mind. Your radial in and radial out can vary depending on your velocity, your orbital eccentricity, or even angularity. It just really depends on what's going on with your orbit and your parameters. For further details on normal and antinormal, your inclination, such as a polar orbit, so imagine the North Pole and the South Pole here, it's more expensive to do it when you're in orbit, typically speaking, than doing it from the ground. The first northern orbit, or the first polar orbit, wasn't achieved until far later in the execution of the space program, because it's very expensive. And of course, we can quickly cover delta V, so that you understand what that is. Delta is the change in something, and V being the velocity. You'll hear this in regards to rockets and various other spacecraft. Delta V is how much velocity, the change in velocity that you can get from the spacecraft's engines as well as its fuel. And as the fuel is depleted, the vehicle becomes lighter, therefore requiring less thrust to move it. Or it goes faster the lighter it is. It's quite interesting. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll be happy to take a look at them. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and ring that bell for more notifications. Talk to you then.